In the late 18th century, France had, like most Catholic nations, missionaries working across Asia, but Vietnam was in the midst of a civil war. There, although the Li dynasty ruled as emperors, real power was fought over by the Trinh lords in the north and the Huynh lords in the south. However, in the 1770s, the Huynhs lost a war with the Siamese over control of Cambodia, so the Trinh saw their opportunity to strike and claim all of Vietnam. They managed to kill the majority of the Huynh leaders, but Gia Long escaped and sought refuge with French missionaries. The French then agreed to help him reclaim power, but this alliance broke down because of the French Revolution. Nevertheless, some French soldiers of fortune did travel to Southeast Asia and aided Gia Long in becoming emperor of a united Vietnam. His successor Minh Mang, however, was an isolationist and persecuted Christians, and many Christians were executed after they united with the ethnic Chinese and unsuccessfully rebelled in the 1830s. Then, in 1856, the French joined the British in the Second Opium War, so they already had a force in Asia. And Napoleon III had recently become Emperor of France and sought to expand France's international prestige and holdings. As such, he'd already fought Russia in the Crimean War, expanded French Senegal, and took New Caledonia. And Vietnam was long believed to be an important future naval base, and could act as a counterweight to British dominance in Asia. And in 1857, the new Emperor Tu Duc executed missionaries, giving France a cause for war. So in 1858, along with some Spanish soldiers, the French landed in modern-day Da Nang and captured the city. But the 2,000 troops were quickly surrounded and besieged, and were unable to break out. So some soldiers were left to garrison Da Nang while a larger force set sail for Saigon in February 1859. There they captured the citadel, which had been built by French engineers years earlier, but they were unable to hold it, so just blew it up. But again they were besieged, and counterattacks proved to be too costly. Plus, as the war with China was escalating, many soldiers were taken from Vietnam to aid in an offensive there. And in Europe, the French entered the Second War of Italian Unification against the Austrians, leaving the troops in Vietnam largely ignored and abandoned. So the French tried to make peace, just asking for protection over the Christians. But the Vietnamese knew they had the advantage and refused. So the overstretched French decided to withdraw from Da Nang in March 1860 and strengthen their position in Saigon, which they successfully held until early 1861. That's when the war in China ended, and this allowed a couple thousand troops to be sent to Saigon. So in early February, with naval support, the French were finally able to break through the siege lines and advance to take Mai Tho in April. Tu Duc, however, still refused to surrender any land and hoped guerrillas would stop the French advance. Meanwhile, American sailors had disappeared in Vietnam, so in July 1861, an American ship arrived in Quy Nhon looking for them. However, despite the Vietnamese flying the white flag, the Americans bombarded the fort, razing it to the ground. And in the south, the Vietnamese managed to sink a French boat, but the French retaliated by advancing on Bien Hoa in December. Then, the following March, the French suspected that the Vietnamese were responsible for an explosion on another one of their ships. So they again responded by advancing, this time by capturing Vinh Long, finally persuading Tu Duc to look to make peace. In the peace, Tu Duc allowed the French to trade freely along the Mekong, gave freedom of missionary activity, opened his ports, and ceded land. France received Saigon and three provinces in the south of Cochin China, establishing a foothold in Southeast Asia. And from there, they would go on to bring Cambodia, the rest of Vietnam, and Laos into their empire.